We finally met you, Randy, in person. And normally when people meet each other at long last, it's kind of in passing. We've spent like 29 consecutive hours together.
Yep. Yeah, it's the best day of my life.
Let's start with the Taylor Swift concert, I guess. We had hilariously good seats. Yeah.
So
did not expect that to
so
be
good.
A thing.
We beat Millie Bobby Brown.
Yeah. Yeah, we had better seats than Millie Bobby Brown. And this stunk. Millie Bobby Brown posted that she was there, and I was like, yo, Randy,
hook it up.
Hit up Millie Bobby Brown. And he was like, well, adults typically don't have the phone numbers of children, you idiot. So we didn't meet Millie Bobby Brown. But
yeah, thanks for nothing, Randy.
Yeah.
Yeah, sorry, guys. Just trying my best to not be a creeper in life.
You're hanging out with us, yeah. So you're off to a bad start. Yeah. The world goes on another day, another trauma.
But not for me, not for me. All I think about is karma. We were like, I mean, we had a few, of course, but like we weren't out of control as far as like drunkenness went. The world goes on another day. We were out of control as far as
fun,
just, like,
having fun.
A super fun time. Like, we got back to the hotel last night, and I don't think we were like destroyed or anything, but we were just like on this high of, oh my God, that was so fun. Taylor was insane. It was weird to be at a concert like that and not have to look at the monitors. That was my big takeaway the whole time. You could actually just like follow her around.
Yeah, I think I was drunk on standing.
Well, the reason you weren't drunk on alcohol is because as soon as the show started, I jumped up and knocked your drink out of your hand.
Just smashed it down.
Literally so happy.
Right,
DJ was like, oh, I'm sorry. I don't even care.
Yeah. I knocked out of your hand and I was like, no. And you were like, I am so happy right now. There was a child in front of us. We felt very bad for him. There was this family of four in front of us. Mother, father, boy, girl. And the girl was having a blast. The mother was having a blast, doing a whole lot of Facebook Living.
Yeah, she was Facebook Living the show.
That's just an adult thing. Randy, do you do that? Hopefully not.
God, no.
You just walk around like, hey, I'm at this thing. I'm going to Facebook Live it.
No.
I was at a show once where the person Facebook Lived the entire show. And it's way more annoying than actually videoing, because you can see, like, when you Facebook Live, there's chats and stuff that pop up.
Yeah.
And so it just kept, like, popping up in front of my face the whole time, and it was so distracting.
Yeah.
But thankfully, this person only did it during the first couple acts.
Yeah, so ranking the people in that family. I mean, the mother was very nice. I think she took a picture for us or something.
Yeah.
The daughter was great, super into it. She wasn't on her phone a lot. The father was doing a good
Dragged
job
there.
Of like making sure that everybody
was
happy. And the son was he was sitting down and he was covering his ears.
Wow.
And we felt so bad. It got like, it was distracting for me. I was going to get up during Getaway Car or some bad song and try to find him earbuds. But then when she would play a song that he liked, he would get up and he was air drumming. He was rocking out. He was just being a little twerp.
He was very into the drums.
He was being a twerp, though. He was faking the, like, this is too late. He was trying to get his whole family to go home because he didn't like whatever song it was.
But that's a kid move.
Yeah.
Kids do that.
But I also feel like, as a parent, you know, you're very selective when you ignore your children.
Mm. Yeah.
And so that was I think the parents just selectively going like, we're going to ignore the fact that you are covering your ears. And so we're worried about the kid, but the parents are just like, no. This is what he does.
Well, what was crazy is I realized when we were worried about this kid, we overlooked the fact that like a 7-year-old who had unbelievable seats to Taylor Swift just might be a spoiled brat.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Why didn't we put that together?
Because we were spoiled brats right behind them.
We were spoiled brats. Speaking of spoiled brats, spoiled hats. MVP of the whole weekend is
that
hat.
Right,
we've been trading off wearing that hat. That hat, Randy's the only one of us who hasn't worn this hat.
Yeah.
This thing is a compliment machine.
Yeah.
If you, man, or maybe just people in Atlanta are nice. That it could be that.
No, people are going out of their way to compliment
the hat. A woman in the restaurant today, one of two restaurants this morning, bang, bang, came over to Pete, and I thought that she was like, hey, we got you guys a table. And she was like, I just need to know where you got that hat. That's a fantastic hat.
Yeah.
Men, women, everybody, boys, girls. I think the spoiled kid took the fingers out of his ears for a second and was like, sir, I'm sorry. I'm having a dreadful time. But if you could tell me where you got that hat, it just might turn this terrible day around.
We're not telling anybody where we got the hat either.
It's a secret place.
Hey, Randy, what's up with Stranger Things?
It's going to take place in the summertime.
Ooh.
We're about halfway through the season right now, but it's not coming out until probably next summer because guess what? Biggest season.
Biggest season?
Really?
Yeah, biggest season, going to have the most special effects. It's going to be awesome.
Well, you guys are, to use a Ween reference, like Stranger Things went from making tapes season one, just like making tapes on a little four-track thing, to now a label has signed them and is like, yo, you want studio musicians?
Yeah.
What's that like? Like now there's probably like a green screen in all of your scenes.
Not in all of mine, luckily. Most of them. I get to sort of chill with the practical stuff, which is fun. When you mentioned Ween, I was like, are you going to say that we're waving our dick in the wind? Because we are not waving our dick
yet.
In the wind.
Season four.
Not this season. No, sir. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a fucking blast.
Which children's like the most now? Because they're hitting that age. They're hitting that age.
They are all wonderful, wonderful people.
I would love if Mr. Clark improvised some, you know what, lines.
I've had enough of your shit.
Yeah. You know what, you kids. I will say this, Finn Wolfhard, who plays Mike on the show and has a great, great name. He is 5'8" now.
Uh-oh.
And he was like
Couldn't be me.
Right.
He was like a baby child when I first met him. And I see him at the table read for season three, and he just like walks up to me, and I'm just like, whoa, first off, how old are you? How tall are you? He's like, I'm 16. I'm 5'8". I'm like, Jesus. God bless America.
Must be nice.
They grow up so fast, the kids these days.
What's what's the coolest thing that's happened so far that you've shot that might surprise the audience? That's maybe like a twist.
Oh, like a spoiler?
Yeah.
let's just say.
Yeah, like what's the plot?
Mr. Clark conclusion. Is the Demogorgon.
Ooh, hell yeah.
Secret. That's what you kind of don't notice it, but the Demogorgon does have a mustache.
You're in Godzilla?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I always get them confused. I always get Godzilla
like King
and King Kong. But
I have a friend that's the same way. I have a friend that keeps going like, oh, when's King Kong coming out? I'm like, I don't know. Also, I'm not in that movie,
right.
So
it's
why
like,
would
it's a
I?
Random
is that in the same universe?
It is in the same universe.
Okay.
It is, there's a little teaser at the end of Skull Island in the post-credits where they sort of like throw down these folders to like Brie Larson and who's the is it Hiddleston?
Tom Hiddleston?
Yeah. They like throw down this folder and it's got like all the Godzilla monsters in it.
So what monsters are in that? Because there's a lot of them.
Oh baby, we got all the heavy hitters.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got.
I don't know one monster, like, so you literally need to name them.
We got Mothra, which is like a giant moth.
Okay.
King Ghidorah, who is
adorable.
A badass.
His name's Adora?
Ghidorah.
Oh, I thought you said Adora.
Yeah.
I was like, that sounds more adorable.
That's going to be like the Funko Pop version of King Ghidorah. Adorah, which is, and he's just like really cute. I want to cuddle him.
Kind of king.
I believe Rodan is in there as well. And then a couple others. It's going to be, there's going to be a lot of fights. Lot of monsters fighting each other, which is what we came to see.
Think of Rodan's tweets?
I didn't see them. Are they problematic?
They were, yeah. They canceled Rodan's
show.
Oh, wow.
They brought back Rodan's show, and then Rodan was a huge Trump supporter. And what did Rodan even tweet?
Something about Nazis, I think.
Was it?
I think so. Rodan said that a black person, she compared them to like a monkey. Which was
Valerie Jarrett Planet of the Apes thing.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh God. Yeah.
That's
yeah,
what
yeah.
happened.
And it's so crazy
that
a monster of that size could be crushed by a single tweet.
Yeah,
that's true.
It happened.
But
oh, man, this Godzilla sequel sounds insane. Just crushing these monsters by pulling receipts.
Would if they added Rodan to a project and you knew that like with Rodan comes all of
All the drama.
All of the drama. All the baggage. All of, and, all this and now drama. People are like, why are you working with Rodan? And then like you get judged for something, like you're just doing your job.
Yeah.
How would you strike that balance?
I think I would call Wanda Sykes up and ask her what I should do. I haven't ever really watched Friends.
Whoa.
Yeah, I know this is so fucked up to say like on your podcast. I actually they still, you know, cuz that show still comes on. I forget what network. I think maybe TV Land.
Mm. What?
And I have a Raymond. Everybody Loves Raymond.
Yeah. Okay.
What time?
I like literally all the time. But
I'm about to call my cable provider.
So what? I have a friend who has a show on TV Land called Teachers. If you like funny shows, check out Teachers on TV Land.
You
I'm not on
say,
it.
If you can't,
yeah, what
act,
the hell? How do you have a friend who has a TV show called Teachers, and you plays the most famous teacher on TV is not on that show?
You know,
it's like a personal attack.
I feel personally attacked every time I watch that show and I'm not on it.
Do you ever hit him with the zinger? You know what they say, if you can't act, just act on Teachers.
Yeah. Yeah.
Those who can't act are in the show Teachers.
Those who can't act, play teachers on television.
You're so bad at acting that you can't even teach acting.
Nope.
You have to play,
I have to
a,
play
teacher.
A teacher. Yeah. That's,
do the teachers teach acting?
That's
Is Rodan on the
so
show?
That's if like you're really really bad. If you're a really bad actor, then you have to play an acting teacher.
Henry Winkler
so good in Barry.
Yes.
Oh my god,
you're right. So that's,
he's so good.
That's crazy then. Yeah, I guess we were just proven wrong because he knocks that out of the park.
Oh, he is exactly like an acting
rules.
Teacher that
really?
I know. He is exactly like an acting teacher that I know. The acting teacher is obviously much better at teaching acting than Henry Winkler is, but there's so many things that he does, like mannerisms from that show, that I'm like, God, like, it's so spot on. It's such a great role for him.
Whenever
everything he does,
he's
just like a
I'm,
resurgence.
I'm so glad he's no longer a punchline. He was for a little bit when he was basically all he would do was just Adam Sandler movies.
I was gonna say, he just shows
and Scream.
In Scream, but
he's like the one death in Scream where I'm like, no, don't kill him.
They kill his is like a ceremonial thing. Don't they like string him up on like the field goal post or something? But every time an acting teacher is portrayed in TV or movies, they always are trying to leave the class in a rush, and the only time you see them is when someone's asking them if they can talk after. Mm-hmm. I just watched Adaptation, same deal. He goes to the seminar, to the script writing seminar, and he's trying to talk to the guy after, and the guy's like, oh, and he's trying to get out of there, and it's like, you're talking to people who need help. Some of them are probably going to ask you for help.
Is that Brian Cox?
Who
plays the acting teacher in that?
I don't know. I just know that the Nicolas Cage, there was... More Nicolas Cage than I wanted. Double the Nicolas Cage.
We were on the plane and DJ was watching that movie and he goes,
yeah, he saw me like throw my hands up while watching
the
movie.
He pulls out his earphones. He's like, ugh, this movie, not a good start. It has double the Nicolas Cage that you would want.
Yeah.
That was a Randy Havens TM recommend.
It was. Are you, I sent out a pretty like wide net of like, somebody give me a great Meryl Streep performance.
Mm-hmm.
And A lot of people said Death Becomes Her, which I realize I kind of saw one time at a bar.
It's so good.
I think I'd check it out. It's got like backward bodies and everything like that.
It's Goldie Hawn and Meryl Streep, and they are ladies who are rich and beautiful and are getting a little older, so they're trying to do everything they can to stay young, and they end up getting this.
I remember
formula.
My first The Bucket List. I liked it better first time when it was called The Bucket List, like 40 years later.
So they start taking this serum to stay young, but it turns out that it also
gives
them.
Snake oils.
Yes. Yeah, man. Generally, if
stay
serum
away.
Is on the table, if
anybody
like,
says the word serum, bad idea.
Well, serum is a thing they want to get you on it. They never say like, oh, can you try this serum? They're like, hey, I'd love to get you on this serum.
Yeah.
That sounds horrible.
Don't do it.
Everyone recommended that movie, and I was like, I'm not going to watch that. I'm going to watch Multiplicity instead. Did watch Multiplicity. What a movie. But you had said that Adaptation was, I think there was some like caps lock in there. Like
I said, if you like 100 Michael Keatons, you'll love twin Nick Cages.
Yes, exactly. And, spoiler alert, one of the Nick Cages had a similar affliction to one of the Michael Keatons.
Yeah.
That guy wanted pizza.
It's a good one.
Now it gets the DJ and Randy stamp of gotta watch
it's
it.
It's like sad and funny. And there's one little speech where the more, I'd say, touched brother gives about that he fell in love with this girl in high school and she didn't love him back.
Oh, yeah.
And so the screenwriter brother is like, why? Why did you love her? What, like, you knew that
he said, like, one time I overheard you flirting with this girl and he was like, oh, yeah, I was in love with her. He was like, and then when you walked away, she and her friend started laughing at you. Like, they were mocking you. They were making fun of you. And he was like, oh, yeah, I know. And he was like, what? Well, why were you okay with that? And he said,
because his love was his.
Yeah.
And she couldn't take his love away from him just because she didn't love him back or that she was, like, dismissive.
It's a little... It approaches, but doesn't quite get to, like, the Brandon Flowers, you're not going to deny my love kind of thing. Because he didn't seem to have this love in, like, I won't take no for an answer kind of thing. It's like, I understand that you don't love me back, but this is my feeling, and it's a feeling I have. Good for that brother. And he banged Maggie Gyllenhaal, who I didn't realize, Maggie Gyllenhaal back in the day, pretty good.
Pretty good.
I'm not a huge fan.
Oh, Pete's. No. Pete's.
I used to. Hate Maggie Gyllenhaal because I just don't like any of her roles. Mm. She was awful in the Batman thing. She was actually pretty good in Frank. Did you see Frank?
My God, I love that. Yeah. That's got my boy Scoot McNairy. He's the their manager that hangs himself.
Really?
Yeah.
Good friend
of mine. Brilliant actor.
Whoa. He's he hangs himself. In Frank's head.
Oh, he puts his head on.
And
yeah,
everyone thinks, oh, Frank's killed himself. And they're like, oh, phew, it was just somebody else.
Yeah, if you ever want to watch Michael Fassbender movie with about 5 seconds of Michael Fassbender in it.
Well, if you ever want to watch a Michael Fassbender movie in which they finish the Michael Fassbender movie. Don't watch Snowman.
Don't watch Snowman.
Oh, I love that movie.
That, what was the meme recently? It was like quote this, which is always a thing now, quote this with, like, your favorite movie in, five words.
Oh, five words to describe a movie.
Yeah, and I did, like, Dear Mr. Police, Keep the Change. That movie was so brutal.
Oh, it was, I had such a good time, because I had heard your podcast on it, and
you came on the podcast and shit on it with us.
I had such a great time watching that film. The slow, like, creep in, zoom in on the snowman as you're going, like,
it's just the worst.
Who didn't know that snowmen were not scary?
Yeah.
Like, who was like, oh man, as they're writing the script, they're like, oh man, and then zoom in on the snowman.
Man, the trailer the movie look awesome.
Wasn't there a snowman movie in which Michael Keaton plays a snowman?
Yeah, Jack Frost.
Yeah,
he
plays an actual snowman.
And
yeah.
Was he supposed to be scary?
No. But there is
he just turned into a snowman.
Also a scary movie of Jack Frost where the Jack Frost is like an evil being. This one was like Michael Keaton's like a dad who didn't pay enough attention to his kids, and he gets in like a car accident and turns into a snowman.
We should have a thing in Harvard Square or something like Brunch Presents Snow Day, and it's a day full of snowman-themed movies because apparently they're enough that you could do a day. You could do Michael Keaton one.
Yeah.
What if there was like a Michael Keaton movie where a snowman kept cloning himself, but here's the thing about the snowmen.
Oh,
they
boy.
All have sex with Andrea McDowell
after all right.
Michael Keaton with,
like,
begs them not
like,
to.
I'd watch
like a
that
carrot
one.
Dick.
Yeah. And they
you just like slowly see a carrot come out of the snowman and like point upwards.
Michael Keaton comes
home. Come on, Andrea.
Andrea McDowell is in lingerie and it's just drenched and he's like, what were you doing?
Wait, like, what is it? Isn't it Andy? Andy McDowell?
Is that her name?
Yeah, I think it's Andy.
Whatever.
McDowell.
What have I called her? Andrea McDowell?
Yeah. And then like there's one of the Michael Keaton snowmen just has pizza all over its face.
Yeah. He's like, all right, so it couldn't have been you, but why are you way smaller? Have you melted? It looks like you did something that made you melt.
In the shape of my wife. There's just like a big melt right in the middle.
Breasts are indented on this snowman, and the actress, whose last name is McDowell, is just covered in clearly like cold water with little like clumps of ice.
It's like coal markings just all over her body.
This is...
She's got like scratches from sticks.
This is the sequel that we didn't know we needed.
Yes.
This is the sequel to two movies.
Yes. Maybe adaptation has inspired me. I actually want to take a screenwriting class because I've been starting to have some ideas and I don't know how to put them down on paper. That would be awesome. A multiplicity Jack Frost crossover, but can't do it without McDowell. The project is attached to McDowell. Need her for the iconic Michael Keaton comes home.
Love it.
Sees a drenched McDowell. Has a lot of questions. Rules out pizza to snowman. But also, you have recently signed on. Can we announce this?
Yeah.
You've signed on
to
a project called...
Of course.
So I announced recently, I said I wasn't going to say it because I wanted to actually make it happen before we did anything, because I didn't want anyone to steal the idea.
But we're really so close to production at this point that we have to announce it.
So
the script has been greenlit.
Yes, the script has been greenlit.
By
Pete
us.
Says okay. Yeah, yes. Pete said okay. Can I write this? Yes. It's called Dog Court, and it's a court show in which everybody is played by a dog, and it has a lot of the staples of your classic court show. The main one, the pilot is going to be built around a young dog who is a lawyer, mm-hmm. and he thinks he's going to be made partner.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But now we're giving away stuff. Well, he doesn't get made partner.
Well, here's a TV trick, and just it's a staple. If making partner is in the equation,
they don't get made partner.
You know, nobody in TV has ever been made partner when they think they're going
to be
made partner.
If they're expecting a bonus, they don't get the bonus. If they're expecting to be made partner, they don't. If they're expecting to shtup somebody, they don't shtup that person. But they were in love with their friend all the time.
Yep.
Yeah, all along.
Yes, but also Michael Keaton's clone shtupped them.
Yep.
Yes, that would... What if like it's like Dog Court and it's got like typical court music and it's like starring Emilio, Summer, Tess, all these different dogs in our life. And then at the end,
these are the most interestingly named.
And Andrea McDowell, and it's her, and she's like looking down at her.
She's got peanut butter all over.
She's, oh no.
If someone could just tweet.
But you're attached to the project, though.
Yes. Oh, absolutely. Yes. 100% attached to the project. Trying to get a co-producer credit, honestly. So.
Ooh, what does that mean?
That just means you guys give me a credit because you don't have enough money to pay me.
Okay. Really?
Yeah.
That's right. Sick. Have you gotten those before?
No.
I don't
make
exposure bucks.
Yeah, I don't make any money at all.
So they just don't pay you anything.
They're just like, I get exposure bucks too. They're like, don't you want to be in this movie? And I'm like, yeah. And they're like, well then
you can be in it or you're not.
Well then, here, take this tiny trailer that has a toilet literally underneath the chair that you sit on.
A toilet?
Yeah.
Whoa.
I'm like, ooh.
A trailer with a toilet.
What is your trailer situation on Stranger Things?
My trailer situation on Stranger Things is very nice, actually. Ooh. Yeah, Stranger Things, they're one of the few projects I work on that actually treat me very well. I get what's called a triple banger.
Really?
It is a triple banger.
I've never done that, but
hey,
one day.
You know what?
Fingers crossed.
Yeah. Just...
Keep believing.
Look up to the G-man.
Yeah,
he'll bless you. Mm-hmm. That is a one large trailer that is cut into or split into three rooms, and there's a room with a couch and a desk and a little closet and a mirror and a television and a radio. Oof. And then there's a bathroom, an actual bathroom that you go into.
Nice.
Well, this has been an absolute dream come true. What do you have coming up, Pete?
just enjoying the rest of my summer, and I don't know. We're going to ACL. I'm excited about that.
We're going to Austin City Limits. Do you want to come?
I would love to.
Sorry,
yeah,
booked up.
Seriously?
Oh, all right.
It's all booked.
Okay.
You know what?
Maybe next time.
Not kidding. We've got it. You can come.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
Do you?
We'll
do,
have
would you,
you
come?
Oh,
would
when
you
is
come?
When
if
is
you,
it?
If you could, it's in October. The
Let me check my schedule.
We're bad at a thousand right now.
That would be a blast.
Before we started recording this, I said that Dog Court, we would start hopefully doing recording because it's like a lot of voiceover stuff in October. And you said that you committed to that.
Yeah.
So if we move stuff around, I just did the old Michael Scott to you, which is say you have to stay late and work today.
Yep.
Just kidding. Now you, I can invite you over because you don't have plans now.
Yeah, exactly. I know you canceled your plans. That's pretty brilliant.
Camila Cabello is it?
Cabello.
I don't think she is.